around, and I feel silly about this, but it's just, I'm me. That's true.
Disputably.
Indisputably. I have found that I don't want my neighbors to know, which is really awkward because, like, that's often where my partners are. But also, you know, it's a discomfort, not like a hard line. It's just like, I notice that I'm like much less likely to talk about this arrangement with my neighbors.
I sometimes really wonder what our across the street neighbors think of our house.
Yeah.
They spend a lot of time on their porch in the summer.
Yeah.
And we've never talked to them about it. I should ask Etta one of these days. Like, what do you think is happening in our house?
What do you see?
Because you know neighbors speculate about each other.
Oh, really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
I'm certain that our former neighbor in North Carolina understood
exactly what was happening.
We shared a wall. So.
And until our oldest was born, we didn't have any dressings on the windows. Is that true?
That's true.
That's true.
So they knew. They
knew. Were not. We are naked people.
There's some things that happened in that living room.
Yep.
Oh yeah. Yep. Hi neighbors.
Naked popcorn scraping.
Oh god, I forgot about that.
Ceiling. Scraping. Yeah. Was there an incident?
Like, no. Well, I
you
mean,
know, like the
event.
Surface treatment, the like. The, like,
oh,
sprayed
popcorn.
On, like,
yeah.
like
asbestos or something, like,
Megan and Martin were visiting us, and we wanted to clear it all off, and we decided that that would be a good project for the four of us to do, so we, like, taped up plastic, and put on masks, and took everything else off.
And it was very practical, because that stuff
yeah,
sticks
awful.
To everything. It's terrible, terrible stuff.
And then later I learned that you are supposed to do that by getting it wet and just scraping it off.
Oh.
Did I tell you this?
No, you never told me that there was a solution other than being naked.
Yeah,
there's
that's
a solution
less
to so many things.
Much less dusty. I mean, you can still be naked, but
yeah.
It's less dusty that way.
That's well, next special. Time you all need to do home renovations, I'm happy to photograph it.
Oh well.
Here though.
Anyway, yeah. How old are you?
I feel the same about the neighbors. Like I have no idea what they know or think or how worried I should be about it.
Right.
I mean, I go back and forth between that's none of their business and well, I don't want people to give the impression that we're being disloyal to each other.
Yeah.
Right. I want them to understand that they don't need to worry about like should I be going over and talking to Rose about what I saw.
Totally.
I don't want them to be in that position.
Right.
And we worry about that a lot.
Uh-huh. We have a window that faces right into the other person's house in our kitchen. And I am sure that I don't know what they've seen, but I'm sure that I've kissed people who are not Luke in front of
kitchens are just a great place for making out.
Yeah.
Mm. And we're cooking people. Mm-hmm. Like all of us are cooking people. We spend a lot of time cooking. We spend a lot of time cooking together.
Mm-hmm. And when you bump into each other in the kitchen, it's just
one thing just leads to another.
Yeah.
Usually the same thing.
Yeah, and then I'm fairly out. Most people in my life, if it's the kind of person where you like talk about your weekend and talk about like your life, I'm out with that person.
Mm-hmm.
I am completely out to my mom's side of the family and all my siblings. I am out to my dad and stepmom. I maybe sort of out to one of my aunts. Like, we've never had a conversation about it, but I just, she might not know. I don't know. We haven't had a conversation about it. And I'm really not out to my dad's parents or my other uncle.
So kind of like immediate family and some extended family. Yeah.
And I just, you know, when I first made that decision, it was, you know, more than 15 years ago or something where I really started thinking about it. And I just had this like, oh, my grandparents are really old. It's not going to be an issue. And now they're just way older. But I'm like, it's been like 20 years now and I haven't.
Yeah. I am out. I have no secrets. There's nobody I can think of immediately who I would not feel comfortable talking to about my romantic life. That said, I don't really talk about it. And it's difficult for me to even figure out how to bring up the topic in conversation without it being a specific confrontation with somebody.
Yeah, unless it comes up naturally, like, what did you do this weekend? And, oh, yeah. I spent time with my boyfriend or whatever. It's like, then it comes mm-hmm. up. But otherwise.
Yeah, if you're not having those conversations with someone, it gets really forced. Mm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I'm not out to my uncle because he would think I'm going to hell. And I don't want to have that conversation.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they know I'm going to hell anyway. Like, they've seen enough of my life that, like, they get it. But I still don't want to have that conversation. Yeah, I just really just don't want to have that conversation.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
I was at a wedding one time, and my aunt must have found out somehow. I don't even know. Like, I didn't discuss it with her, but she obviously knew, and she looked at me, and she goes, you know, God is watching you. I was like, cool.
Must be a good show then.
She had some comment for me. Oh, same aunt, yeah. I'm sure. Some comment about adultery and the things that the Bible said about adultery. I was like, oh, that's interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's one take on it.
I'm glad that doesn't apply to me.
Do you feel like there's any, like, these are funny stories of people that we're kind of rolling our eyes at because they, like, are judgy, and but it's not really negatively impacting you, it seems. But are there maybe other situations where you're feeling, like, negative impacts from being out and it being stigmatized, or when you tell people, have you had to deal with anything like that?
I personally am super fortunate. I have never really had to worry. When I discussed this with my mother, she was not comfortable with it, and she made that clear. Mm-hmm. That's okay. I mean, I felt like that's a thing I can deal with, and we worked through that, and that was a little bit difficult for a while, but I never really felt like I had to deal with stigma.
I also don't, I can't think of an incident where me being poly and me being out has had negative consequences in my life. Like, I really can't think of a time where, like, my work hasn't been affected. I've been out at multiple jobs.
I think it helps a lot that we've been poly for so long and have spent that entire time cultivating communities and finding places to live that are safe for us, mm-hmm. for better or worse.
That's so great.
Yeah.